Hi guys, I hope you're having a good day. I know from comments a lot of you, like me, are very interested in FSR, AMD's Fidelity FX Super Resolution, and potential answer to Nvidia's very successful DLSS. My initial thoughts on FSR were that it was very promising, and I'll put a link here to those of you that are interested in that. But the big questions were, how quickly can AMD roll this technology out, and how does it stack up directly against an ever-improving DLSS? We do now have several new pieces of information, at least regarding that first part. The biggest advantage of FSR is that it is not tied to proprietary NVIDIA technology and tensor cores like DLSS, and AMD seek to make the most of this. Both Unity and Unreal Engine now support FSR, and while I'm not a developer, the instructions on how to use it in Unity are literally one sentence, so I'm fairly confident in saying that it's very easy to implement. Unity developers can enable FSR by enabling DRS on your HDRP quality settings and selecting Fidelity FX Super Resolution 1.0 under the upscale filter option. That's it. That's all it takes to enable in Unity, and the rest is tweaking. I'm sure there are a few subtleties to it that go over my head as someone who isn't a developer, but, well, that seems pretty straightforward to me. Unreal Engine works a little differently, but the principle is much the same. It is just a question of enabling FSR if a developer wants a DLSS-like performance boost without paying Nvidia for the privilege. Having engine-level support for FSR is going to be massive. It literally doesn't make sense for FSR to not be included in forthcoming games on either engine or to not be enabled in future patches for existing games. It's not just those two engines either. FSR is open source, and that source code is now available to everyone, so any developer can just add FSR whenever they like, although I am sure it will take some time to integrate into their engines, so this won't happen overnight. Doing a little digging, I also found this slide showing support for GeForce 900 series and even Intel UHD graphics, so support back to 2014 hardware. Practically everyone will be able to use FSR soon. And that brings me to my next point, actually. You don't have to take my word for any of this. If you want to check out FSR today and you don't have one of the games that supports it right now, AMD have made a little demo you can download and try out yourself. I'll put the link in the description, but I doubt you'll have to wait very long until it's in something you play. And that's even if you play on Xbox, as FSR is being included in the Xbox Game Development Kit. I've only had a DLSS capable card for a few months, and in games like Metro Exodus, it is astonishing. But to have a similar ability, and you might notice I'm saying similar because there are some differences between FSR and DLSS, but similar performance enhancements for GPUs in potentially any game is massive. So, I know a lot of you are interested in this already, but I am going to keep following this because the more I learn and the more I see, then the more I am convinced that near lossless upscaling is the biggest thing to happen to PC graphics since, rasterization probably. Global illumination and technologies that allow for better detail are nice, but games already look amazing in the hands of talented developers. But it's about getting that into the hands of more gamers. That's the most important thing, I feel. You may disagree, but that is just my opinion. So let me know in the comments what you think about this, and if you find a DLSS-enabled game that implements FSR officially, I cannot wait to do a head-to-head between the two. Anyway, I have another video to edit and a new test system to put together on what is probably the hottest weekend of the year so far. So, hope you found this video interesting, and I'll see you next time.